On today's show,
we break down Dirk joining the 30,000 point club and what his legacy is moving forward.
Dirk's personality is just as memorable as his game. We've compiled some of the funniest moments from his career.
And the Suns gorilla mascot slides into a little fill-in-the-blank fun.
It's Wednesday, March 8th. The Starter starts now!
Good evening, Sweet World, and welcome to The Starters. Whether you're listening to the podcast, joining us live on NBA TV right now, or a little bit later on YouTube, we're very happy to have you. I'm J.E. Skeets, and alongside me, as always, that's Tass Mellis.
It's going to be a Dirkus circus in here today.
Tomb, it's right. International man of mystery, taking it to the max, Lee Ellis.
Friend.
Lily.
Lily, and last, certainly not least, over there, a man who will be paying off his pick'em loss. It's Trey Kirby.
Ayo!
TK, first things first, what do you got for us?
Well, I'm here at the internet looking for your best tweets at hashtag the starters.
Okay, that's enough, Trey. March Madness.
Already.
Has arrived. Get rid of your computer. There's no need for that
Sweet.
Tonight. Yes, you lost the February pick'em contest. We got a March Madness sort of vibe. A whole lot of messy things for you today. First things first, a little challenge here. You need to eat this pie in 30 seconds.
That's not a challenge for Trey.
Without your hands.
Okay, big deal.
So here we go. When the timer's ready, the pie looks good.
Look at that.
It's a
coconut cream here.
Oh,
nice peaks on this
beer is going to get real messy. All right, we got the timer. Let's get it going. Good luck, sir. Go. How much can he take down? It's in the beard.
I don't know if the beard's a help or a hindrance right now.
I'd like to point out right now, too.
He's eating with his forehead.
You have multiple challenges throughout tonight's show, and you will not be cleaning up after any of these. So, up the nostrils.
Get back in there.
Come on, man.
Hey, that beard should be able to absorb at least half of that.
30 seconds. Oh, you're almost done. Oh, you took down a good chunk. Your beard took down a good chunk.
It's coconut season here in Atlanta. Go get it.
All right. March Madness has begun here.
Nice. You're no Kobayashi, but that sounds good.
Tasty, at least?
You look like Santa Claus.
Really good.
Okay, it's good. That's good.
The
All right.
problem is you can't breathe through cream in your nose. I mean, your mouth is also filled with it. It's basically impossible.
Okay, while you chew, let's get into the actual NBA content on tonight's show. Again, you won't be cleaning up, sir. Guys, if you missed it last night, Dirk Nowitzki did what only five other NBA players have done before him, reached 30,000 career points. His historic moment came off, fittingly, a fadeaway baseline jumper, sent the fans in Cuban into a state of hysteria. So let's play a little three-on-three here. Dirk, 30K edition. TK, if you can now talk to us, we have some cues.
Can't get a deep breath. I can talk, but I cannot breathe. Anyways, maybe it was that scorching hot first quarter. Maybe it was the hug fest when he finally got to 30,000 points. Or maybe you're just a big-time Yogi Ferrell fan. Guys, what was the best part of Dirk's milestone night?
I think it was Dirk's shooting coach, Holger Geschwinder. Holger Geschwinder.
What a name.
What a fantastic name. Dirk's shooting coach for the last 22 years. He met Dirk when he was a 16-year-old kid in 1995. They're still working on his game, and this reaction, crying out in the stands, proves to men you can cry any day. It's entirely fine. But these two, as Dirk said to NBA TV afterwards, they're still working on it. They're still working on his jump shot. 22 years, that relationship, still going to see that reaction. That was the best for me.
Maybe he was crying because he doesn't have a job anymore.
He's like, he's hit 30,000. Now what am I going to do?
He's employed by the Mavs as a full-time coach as well. I don't think Cuban will let him go. He'll get an honorary contract like Dirk did, I'm sure.
That was a great moment.
I think just doing it at home in front of his own bench, in front of Mark Cuban, in front of the Dallas Mavericks fans, against an old rival, even though obviously Kobe and those guys aren't there anymore. Just perfect, because if he'd done this on the road in some place,
I agree.
You know, it just wouldn't have had the same sort of impact that it did. But for him to do that in front of everyone, and you saw Mark Cuban just run out there and hug him, it was amazing.
I think it was also cool how he came out of the gate on fire in this game. You know, he hit the first two shots for the Mavs, he continued to roll, he was at 5 for 5 at some point. It was like, it quickly became not if he'll do it tonight, it's just going to be when. And, you know, it obviously came very early in the second quarter. And I sort of also liked that the game continued a little bit after he hit the fadeaway on the baseline, and we had a little bit more play, and then he ends up hitting the three, and then the timeout, and everyone just going bonker. That was a very, very cool moment. Cuban was crying there, like, he was very into it.
Yeah, one thing that angered me, the Lakers doubling Dirk, I know he scored a lot of points, but yeah. You got to double him on his night. They put out T-shirts. They all knew that he was going to score 20 awesome. Points. He just went at it.
And in a win as well, too. Yeah. All right, Trey, next question.
All right, Dirk is an MVP, an NBA champion, and the best European to ever play in the league. Might be tough to narrow this down to one thing, but what is Dirk's legacy?
I think the first thing that comes to mind when you think about Dirk is that one-legged fadeaway.
Right.
Yeah, he's done that forever. And I think it's the mark of a true champion that you see now so many players try to emulate what Dirk does. And it's not just big guys. It's not just big guys in the post who are trying to do it. Everyone is trying to work this into their repertoire because they've seen how effective it's been for Dirk. Obviously, LeBron, Durant, those guys. Porzingis coming through, a young guy. But even some point guards like Kyrie Irving, Steph Curry, these guys who can get shots off at any time, they're even trying to work in a Dirk one-legger into their game. And people are sort of working on their own adaptions of it. But we know that anytime you see a guy sort of post up, stick that one leg out and fade away, they're doing the Dirk.
And that will be forever.
Yeah.
You know, as long as the NBA goes, someone does that move, the broadcaster, us, whoever it is going to say, oh, he's doing a Dirk. I mean, on the playground, I mean, it will forever be the Dirk, that one-legged fade. It's going to be the best statue of all time, I think.
Oh, yeah.
When that gets made outside the AAC there, that's going to be a great statue.
Undoubtedly.
I think another thing for me with his legacy, and it's interesting, right, because Dirk had a legacy before he won the title, and it wasn't that kind. I mean, nowadays, everybody loves Dirk. You're hard-pressed to find someone who's not a Dirk fan, truly. But it wasn't always the case before he didn't win the title. You know, obviously had lost in the finals, had the MVP year where they lost in the first round. That was a shock. But when he went in 2011 and put together, I still think, one of the more impressive playoff stretches in NBA history over that 21 games, you know, averaging 28, 8, 2.5 assists, and then upending the first, you know, the LeBron era Heat there in their first finals for that 2011 title. That really, I mean, once you had that, that's the only one he ever got ultimately, but that's fine. You just need one. And to do it against LeBron, obviously going to be one of the best players known ever, that was just so, so sweet. So many people were suddenly back on the Dirk train, how great he was.
Yeah, what you guys just said, obviously what we're going to remember him by, but to get to those moments, he had to overcome obstacles. And people thought they had him figured out. Basically, just get a tall, long guy, get all up in him in 2006 and 2007 when, you know, they gave away that first-round series against the Golden State Warriors. The Warriors took that series.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But to get over those obstacles, Dirk had to drive and learn and show people that, hey, I can just go by you. And he wasn't just relying or settling on the shot. And you remember this 2006, this famous, famous play in the San Antonio Spurs series. But, you know, before he perfected the jump shot, he had to drive to figure things out. Those were his obstacles. Those were the moments where he figured out, you know what, I got to do whatever I got to do. And, you know, that was the variety in his game. Like, we always remember the jump shot, but he was obviously able to put it on the floor.
And also, we need to not forget, and look, he's still playing. Dirk's not done yet, and he's, by the sounds of it, he's got another year in him. But he was one of the most clutch players that we've ever seen, obviously, over the last 10, 11, 19 years, really, with this guy. I mean, ESPN Stats and Info, since his rookie season, Dirk has the best plus minus in the NBA in your clutch time stats. And that's obviously 5 minutes to go, 5-point game.
Yeah.
I mean, he delivered time and time again, hitting big shots when the game was close.
And that's when you talk about his variety as well. It wasn't just that one shot. It was driving, getting the line, hitting threes, everything.
All right, Trey, one more question as he continues to pull
go
out.
Go get it, baby.
Wow, man.
It smells like a whole coconut in my nose over here. Dirk currently number 6 all-time NBA scoring list, just 1,414 points behind one-time scoring leader Wilt Chamberlain, who's now at number 5. Dirk has said he's playing another year.
Right.
So will he crack the top 5?
He gets it. I think the last two seasons, he's been between 1,300 and 1,400 points. Now, if he averages 10 points the rest of the year, he'll have to get 1,200 next season. He's going to go out with a bang and get to that 1,200 mark because he's not going to reach quite the last 2 years what he's done. But I think him playing into his 20th season means he's feeling good. You know, he's announced that he wants to play one more year. Again, it's going to be his 20th. He's not doing it just to sit on the bench. I think 1,200 is an attainable number. He'll get there. He'll go top 5.
It's an attainable number if he plays 82 games.
Yes.
And that's been the thing that he's had to overcome the last couple of years is playing enough games.
He doesn't even have to make that.
No, because
that
even,
many
if
games.
You're, even if you're being kind and you say he scores 15 points per game over 75 games, he would still be under
you'd come
your
up
1,200
short,
mark. And that's given him some points, obviously, this year still as we
I'm
go.
Giving him about
he'll just be short.
16 or 17 on average per game over 70 games next year.
All right, well, we'll see. We'll be cheering him on. Okay, lots more still to come on tonight's show, especially when it comes to Trey's March Madness pick'em payoff. Please, don't go anywhere. for the starters, let's play a little fill in the blank before we continue with the pick'em payoff madness. Trey, you got some questions for us.
That's right. Another night, another dreamer. I mean, another crazy stat line for Russell Westbrook. But this time, it's not a triple-double that has the people talking. It's a career-high 58 points for Russ in a loss to the Trailblazers, second most by any player this season. Guys, fill in the blank. Westbrook's career night was blank.
What do you got?
Wasted.
Wasted?
Yeah.
Wow.
Because you have a career night, you shoot 58 points. You want to remember that forever. You want the box score. You want to tell your grandkids. And you look at it and you see a loss. And you're like, I don't really want to remember this night. I mean, it was an incredible performance. His stamina is unbelievable, how he can continue to play at this level. But ultimately, he's going to forget about this game.
Yeah, it was a shame. They gave up 126 points.
Yeah, there was not a lot of defense in this game.
You can't score 58 on a good percentage. He was had a far better percentage than he normally shoots. He was 54% in this game. You can't lose.
Yeah,
his defense wasn't ready to scramble around him. And he was doing his part defensively. Hmm. The other four guys were not. And they were scoring fine. It was just the defense that let him down.
I don't disagree with your answers. I went with a little different here, though. Exhibit AO58 MVP. And what I mean by this, guys, is...
Who knows?
This game really was... if you were pro Westbrook winning MVP, this game could make a case for it.
Yeah.
As long as you think it's just sort of the best individual performer and it doesn't have to do with team success when it comes to MVP, then the guy goes for 58 points, did everything he could. I mean, he was a +7 when he was out there.
Yeah.
His team was way worse when he was off, and that was the difference maker. But you can also look at this game and go, if you're more of a fan of maybe Kawhi winning or LeBron, or obviously Harden, you're going to look at this game and go, well, yeah, okay, great stats. Who cares? His team didn't win. And you still got to have those W's when it comes to the MVP. So I could see both sides of the ledger using this game as an example. It just depends how you look at MVP and how you define it.
That's fair. Yeah, if you value wins, here's another case.
Right. Yeah.
And the Thunder fell to 4-8 when he shoots 30 or more times.
Interesting. All right, Trey, next one.
All right, a wild gorilla was spotted on the loose in Phoenix. It happened in the fourth quarter last night when the Suns mascot, the gorilla, performed a daring slide through the lane to save a rogue drumstick while the game was in action on his side of the court. Truly bananas. Guys, fill in the blank. The gorilla slide was smoother than a blank.
An oil slick on an iceberg. Hmm. I just always wanted to say that.
Oh, wow. You used smoother
than an oil slick on an iceberg. Right? It was unbelievable move by the gorilla.
It was.
Like, you dropped the stick, you made an error, but then you covered up for it by just sliding out there, getting out of there real quick, didn't hurt anyone. Scared Boyan a little bit, but that's it.
I thought he was goofing around at the start, but he was actually looking out for the player's health and
safety. Right.
And
that's
right. Got in and got out.
We're lucky that players don't play in the post anymore, huh?
He had
a free lane to slide in there.
Would have taken somebody down.
Yeah.
That's exactly
I wrote smoother than John Legend's voice.
Hmm. Oh, you love
Not that. Many things smoother than John Legend.
I wrote a Rob Thomas and Santana hit.
Oh, the guys are thinking the same thing
here. Yeah.
Speaking of music, March Madness continues here with the Trey Pick'em Payoff. All right, Trey, this
What's
one's
next?
just as weird as the last one. Kelly coming in here.
Oh, boy.
So, Trey, you have 30 seconds to chug a full shoe of milk.
You're a shoe
milk?
Guy, so this
yeah,
is...
Yeah, we're calling this Milkfoot.
Oh, milk.
So, yeah, keep going, Kelly. Keep.
How much milk can fit in here?
All right, so, and here's the thing.
Coming
out the top here. All right.
That's the spirit.
Well, why are you drinking it from that way? All right.
It's leaking, man.
Okay, let's go. And if you don't finish it... he's going, though.
Now, whose shoe is this?
This is Matt Bonner's shoe.
He doesn't want it back.
Milk Bonner lended us this shoe. I don't know how it smells. I don't know if you wore it.
Oh, he's done it.
That's took it down like 20 seconds.
Oh, my God.
That's the perfect dessert.
All right.
Coconut milk.
Yeah.
Those aren't sound effects.
Sop it up.
There we go. All right. Delicious.
More to come. You destroyed the Milkfoot challenge.
We got what, 2% over here? 100% gone.
Quick break when we return. We'll highlight some of Dirk's funniest moments. No shortage of clips with this guy. If you're just joining us, Trey is paying off his pick'em loss from last month. It's a March Madness theme. He took down a pie with no hands and did the old Milkfoot challenge.
It's making you cross-eyed looking in that foot.
Oh man, look at that table. It looks like Joel McMillan's eating Chinese food. All right, shout out to our buddy Joel. Okay, guys, we already discussed Dirk joining the 30,000 point club and how unbelievable that achievement is. But as great as Dirk is on the court, I think he's just as entertaining off of it. So the starters here put together a little tribute to some of Dirk's funniest moments.
I'm Dirk Nowitzki, and I approve this message.
Dirk joined the Maverick 13 years ago as a skinny kid from Germany with what he describes as a goofy haircut.
I must score so many points, it'll make your head spin.
I have a pen. I have an apple. Apple pen.
What is my NBA nickname?
Your NBA nickname is the Dunking Deutschman.
I made literally billions of billions of baskets.
I would have also accepted these ones. Dirk Diggler, the German Wunderkind, the Germinator.
I know how to win an NBA title, believe me.
The 7-foot schnitzel.
I got too much Monte.
Der Dribblemeister und der Dunkenmeister.
Very nice.
Born down in the Dennis town.
I'm a real American, trust me.
Born in the USA, I was born in the USA now.
Guess what day it is? Guess what day it is? Anybody?
Ding, 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 ding.
What the maps say? Champ, 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 champ. What day is it, champ?
It's game day.
What?
Starting five news team, led by late anchor Dirk Nowitzki.
Excuse me, bro.
Stay classy, Dallas.
Who you trying to get crazy with, S.A.? Don't you know I'm loco?
Dirk Nowitzki off the lead pass.
That may be the last time we see Dirk ever dunk the basketball.
Well, he threatened to throw a basketball. Now he's going with the baseball, and he just about airmailed.
Nowitzki, 3-3,
last year, especially, nobody really believed he had any.
Oh my God! Oh! Shut it down! Let's go home!
Back in the game in the second quarter.
You know, play out of season, and I think, like I said, the moment.
Should have been ready for the big German.
Clearly, Dirk is a tough guy, although the most painful thing may have been his rendition of We Are the Champions. You said you worked on that? Seriously?
I think Dirk wants to come over and help out on the review. That one guard, he is bound and determined to not let Dirk get any closer to that review.
Nowitzki. Schäfer
Nowitzki. I've been looking for freedom. I've been looking so long. Rider. I've been looking for freedom. What you say? Still the search goes on.
Wow.
There it is. Top six in scoring, but maybe number one overall in the very funny department. Dirk is hilarious.
Dirk didn't need any help, but that was well edited. Here we go.
Baby! March Madness pick and payoff continues. All right, Trey.
Bring it on. What's your next
day? Milk a cow now.
It's simply called...
What is that?
It's simply called pudding search, but here's the thing. Kelly here has a niblet of corn that she's going to drop into this vat of chocolate pudding.
How much pudding is this?
5 gallons.
Drop it in. Here we go. Now mix it up. Let's mix it up if we can.
Well, I'm going to tell you, it's easy to find so far. But there now, not so much.
Okay. And 30 seconds to find the corn.
All right.
Good luck with this one.
Here we go.
And go. He's got a technique here, it seems. How thick? Is it heavy?
I mean, it's heavy. But
Trey's got two young kids. He knows what this feels like.
I don't want to lose track of the corn, you know?
Oh, this is where the saying comes from.
Oh, the proof is in the pudding. The niblet. Whoa.
No, I don't think so. I think it's just a pudding lump. It's like it's a simple pudding lump.
Yeah, I didn't think you were going to be able to find this one.
It's as hard as finding a niblet in a 5-gallon bucket of pudding.
That's it. Maybe you should try eating some. Maybe it'll help you. Maybe you'll find it just by chance.
Not in this one.
All right. Well, nope. keep looking during the commercial break. When we come back, Lili's very solid play, and we'll have one more challenge.
This is very cold, though. Very cold and thick.
Apparently 34 boxes of pudding went into that.
It's like you're wearing gloves.
Oh, man. All right, back with the starters. Trey getting messy today here on the starters. Part is his pick'em payoff for losing the month of February. He's ate a pie with no hands, did the old milk foot challenge. Then he had to try and find a piece of corn in a vat of chocolate pudding. No dice, eh? Couldn't find it during the commercial break?
No, I've been searching.
Okay.
There's a lot of, you know, pudding chunks. I don't know what you call it.
Pudding chunks.
Curls.
Yeah. Just keep smoothing it out. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
All right,
buddy.
Let's get to tonight's pick and play.
Being back on the farm.
We've started this in March here, and well, we're split. We got Lee and Tess taking the Magic at home, and Trey and I are taking the Bulls. I don't think Dwayne Wade's a go with this one, though. Just a little FYI for everyone.
That's right.
Lili, VSP.
OKC for a seafood play from the Portland Trailblazers. The ball fizzes around over to Alan Crabb. Feed the crab, and he will score. He knocks in that three-pointer. We've seen this a bit from the Blazers this year. Here it is again. Zip, zip, fizz, and bang. That's what I call a very solid play.
Could we get Trey to do the thumbs up too on the very solid play? I mean, I just...
And that's what I call a very solid play.
No corn, eh?
No corn. Oh, but that's... I got a lot of pudding.
We got time for one more. All right, this one, it's really simple. We're going to throw you some eggs. And you're going to smash them on your head. Nice catch. Oh, man.
I'm going for an alley-oop here. Come on, faster, man.
Oh, boy.
Oh!
That was too much fun.
Oh.
Tell me you're going out right after the show. Oh! Strange. What a grab. All right, Trey, way to pay off.
This big man's got hands.
Way to pay off that
pick-up. You guys know I don't wash my hair.
Yeah, it's going to smell in the office.
You've got pretty good coordination here,
Oh, come on. It's not our pick-up loss.
Whoa.
Oh, that was a hard one.
All right.
Yuck.
Apologies to the cleanup crew for this one.
And farmers.
Shout out to Kelly.
Also chickens.
Carlos, thanks for helping us.
Oh man, this is honestly a lot of eggs. Are we done?
Now here's the best part. You gotta make a cake.
All right, thanks for joining us, folks. And remember, March Madness just peaked for 2017.
Brace the night, people.